Hey there, folks. Welcome back to the Judge Timbers channel. Today, tonight, this afternoon, whenever you're watching this, we're going to be discussing Hey Bulldog, of course, off the Beatles soundtrack album, Yellow Submarine. But you know, if you're watching my channel and you know the Beatles, I'm not posting this because of that. I'm posting it because I'm in a real Beatles mood with all these new Beatle releases we have now and then just coming out. I'm not sure when I'm going to post this lesson, but it's probably out already. And we've also got new deluxe versions of the Red album and the Blue album. And I don't know about you folks, but I was a kid in the 1970s. So the Red and the Blue albums were everything to me. That's how I discovered the Beatles. It's kind of my Beatles anthology. My Beatles one were the Red and the Blue albums. So I love those albums. And I'm so glad we have a deluxe version with some more great songs, including Hey Bulldog. And I think it's such a great choice. I think this song has really, really risen on the Beatle charts, you know, especially for deep hardcore fans. So here's Hey Bulldog. Now, if you know the song, as I'm sure you do, there's no acoustic guitars on this, as far as I know. You can't hear anything. It's really an electric guitar song, piano song, very hard rock song. So I'm just going to give you an acoustic version of this. It's not really a good one to play on acoustic guitar, in my opinion. But I think it is a fun song to play around with on acoustic guitar. And I think it's a good one, especially for any beginner guitarists out there. And I know there are some. This is a great song to practice the riff. You know, it's nice to know just some riffs just to practice your fingering on a guitar. You know, Day Tripper's a great riff. I Feel Fine. Well, Hey Bulldog is another great riff, and it's probably the easiest one, and it sounds good. So let me give it to you on acoustic guitar for what it's worth. Of course, my cover version was all electric guitar and piano and blah, blah, blah. But have fun with this one, as always. So the guitar is in standard tuning. I think all the guitars were in standard tuning. There's no capos on this one. So we're going to start, I'm going to start with the riff. I'm going to spend some time on the riff because that's really the best part of the song, I think, for acoustic guitar. And then I'll just kind of give you the chords. So we're going to start on the A string, the fifth string on the B note on second fret, right? You can play that twice. I'm going to do this slow. So two Bs there. Then open D, back to the B. So it starts first four notes. And then you walk up on the D string, two, three, four, two, three, four. So again, B twice, open D, back to B, then walk up two, three, four on the D string. So in slow time. One more time. In more real time. So just practice that. It sounds pretty good, and it's a fun riff to play. And then the second part, we'll call it the other phrase of the riff, starts out the same way with the B, twice. Now just walk down. The only difference is walk down, four, three, two. So slow, the whole thing slow. Then walk down, four, three, two. That's the riff. That's probably the most fun part of the song. And it's just, you just want to practice guitar. That's a nice riff to play. Then we're going to start. I'm going to play a B7. You can play a B, a B7. And sometimes I think they go to a B minor. It's a little hard to tell. It's kind of I've got to listen to the new mix of this song. It's a little messy in the mix, I think. But I'm going to play a B7. So, sheepdog, standing in the rain. That's an F sharp minor, right? Barred on the second fret. And then back to the B7. Bullfrog. And then F sharp minor. Doing it again. Then we're going to go to an A chord. Some kind of F sharp minor. To an E chord. Then an E7. Back to A. F sharp minor. Back to the B7. So that's the verse. So again, B7, F sharp minor, back to B7, F sharp minor, now to an A, F sharp minor, to E, E7, back to A, F sharp minor to B7. Now, you can talk to me. Now, this part, you can go to a B minor. I would suggest a B minor. Now, I would normally play my B minor at 2nd fret, but if you're going to do the walk-up, I run out of finger. I can't stretch my finger that far. So I'm going to do the B minor here, and you're really just playing the top of the B minor. I'm going to play the B minor at the 7th fret bar chord, and then you're just going to walk up on the 5th string, on the A string, so it's, you can talk to me, just walk up half steps. Then to an E minor. I'll play that barred on the 7th fret. Now you're going to walk up the fourth string, so the D string.
You can talk to me. If you're lonely, you can talk to me.
So we'll do that one more time. A little hard to play on electric guitar. It's really easy. An acoustic's a little hard this way, but that's why I say this isn't a great song to play on acoustic by itself. So we're going to walk up B minor, but you're really just playing the top, maybe two or three strings. Just walk up on the 5th string, A string. Bit of a stretch. Then an E minor. Walk up on the 4th string. Stretch. And then I'm going to go back to B minor, E minor, and then you're into the riff. And then everything's the same. I'm not going to teach the solo. I gave it my best shot on the solo. I'm not a lead guitarist, as you all know. It's what my good friend Carl Reed from England calls it. When he Carlifies a solo, makes it a little easier. I Timified that solo. But it's a fun one. There's great lessons for it on YouTube. I watched a little bit and just gave it my best shot. So now the only other part is the outro, right? Because the solo is just played under the verse chords. The outro is the same riff. First part's the same, so it's just like we did before, starting on the B. But now you're going to go down, going to start on F sharp. So the chords would be B, B7, outro, F sharp minor. But if they want to do the riff, same riff as the beginning. Now it's the same second part of the riff, except instead of playing it on the B string, you go to the F sharp on the 6th string, on the low E string. Same exact riff, just played one string up. I guess we'll call it up to the low E string. So one more time, we'll do it slow. Now to the F sharp. Open A, back to F sharp, then walk down on the A string, 4-3-2, just like the other one. Whoops. And it just plays out that way. So, folks, I think that's everything you really need for Hey Bulldog. Again, difficult song to play. There's probably a way. I didn't really do a arrangement on acoustic guitar for this. But it's a fun song. It's a great Beatles song, Hey Bulldog. If you don't know it, check it out on Yellow Submarine or the new Deluxe Blue album. But if anything, I think it's just a fun riff to play on guitar. It's also a fun riff to play on piano. I don't play piano, but I could play that riff. So it's a lot of fun on this song, as always. All about fun on the Judge Timbers channel. So, folks, I hope you're enjoying Now and Then. I haven't heard the new version yet. It comes out tomorrow based on my filming. I just watched the 12-minute documentary tonight. I had tears in my eyes. It was just beautiful. I'm so excited about that. That will have been released by the time I post this. And then we'll have the video, the Peter Jackson video, coming out right after that on Now and Then. And somewhere in the mix, I think the Blue and the Red albums are all coming out with the new mixes and all that stuff. So it's a fun time to be a Beatles fan in 2023. I really appreciate your support and joining me on the Judge Timbers channel. I'll see you all real soon. Take care.